Hey guys, Clumsy here, and welcome back to Transport Fever. Now, I have a few updates and news to share. I'm not sure if everyone is familiar with it, but I had to sift through some of the forums in order to get the real deal of what's been happening. Now, this might be a bit of a different episode than the usual ones we have, at least in the beginning, because I really want to share this with everyone. I'm sure a lot of you are also wondering. If you went through the Steam Workshop recently, you'll notice that the DMA mods are gone. Yeah? And if you read those before, the description in DMA mods say that if it was not really FX2K who made those mods, it's Danny66. And Danny66 is actually a guy who makes mods not in Steam Workshop directly, but he uploads them in the Transport Fever homepage. So transportfever.net, I think, is the page. So he uploads his mods there, and FX2K uploads them in turn to Steam Workshop, so everyone can have access to it in the Steam Workshop. Yeah. But all in all, this means that the mods are done by Danny66. Now, recently, you might have noticed all the mods are gone. I did say this as well. All his mods are gone, not only in Steam Workshop, but also in the Transport Fever website. So they're gone. You can't get them anymore. And I was wondering why, and I came across this post in Transport Fever website in the forums. So apparently there's been an issue. Now, if you want to see the full details of this issue, you can go and take a look. If you see below in the video description, I have the link there to the mods list, right? And if you see, there is a Transport Fever tab, which just has the link to the Steam collection for the list of mods. Now, I put a note there as well, saying what happened to the DMA mods, and the link to the actual forum post, which discusses the issue in detail, right? But to just let everyone know, what happened was, apparently, supposedly, there was one anonymous guy who let the moderators know that one or a few of the models that Danny66 have been using has been quote-unquote stolen from another game, from another modder, from a different person. So this game is Microsoft Train Simulator. They call it as MSTS. And apparently that game had mods there for a couple of trains. And apparently they say Danny66 might have stolen the models from that game. So there is a different modder who did these models and then put them in MSTS. These models, they say Danny66 took and used for his DMA mods here in Transport Fever without the permission of the original modder. And that is the main issue. So it is like a copyright claim, a copyright issue, which the developers, the forum moderators cannot really tolerate. So what they did was to investigate, and they did see that the models are exactly alike. So they gave a chance to Danny66 to voice out his opinion and his side of the story. But when they did this, when they tried to get his side, the only thing Danny66 said was, "Delete my account, delete all my mods." So he didn't defend himself, he didn't say he stole it, he didn't say anything, he just said, "Delete my account and delete all my mods." And all further efforts to try and get his side of the story was not fruitful. So that's what the moderators did eventually. They deleted all his mods from the site, and the FX2K also removed all the DMA mods from the workshop, and so no one can download them anymore, unfortunately. It's a sad day for a Transport Fever community, because those mods are one of the best in my opinion. But yeah, if there's an issue like that and you can't really go around it. I wish the only thing the modders wanted to do, the moderators wanted to do, was to have Danny remove some of the stolen, quote-unquote stolen models, maybe. Remove those specific mods, but not everything. But for some weird reason, Danny decided to just delete everything, or request to delete everything. Even those mods which were not really being accused of being stolen. So that's a sad turn of events, and as a result, we don't have DMA mods anymore. Now, if you notice, I do still have them in my game, because for some reason you can still have them. They don't get deleted even if the mods aren't in the Steam Workshop already. If you downloaded them before, you should have them still with you. Yeah. Unfortunately, we cannot share this further, so please don't ask me to send you the files, because the Transport Fever developers are very strict about it. So they don't allow uploading the mods to any other sites, and since they deleted it from their site and from the Steam Workshop, it's not moral to upload it anywhere else and to share it with anyone else. So we can just assume that the mods are gone, unfortunately. Yeah, it's a sad day, but that's how it is sometimes. Hopefully someone else steps up and makes awesome mods, keep the game alive. On some bit of good news though, I did see that there is a forum post from the developers from Urban Games, and they said that they're actually, so they announced that the Wikipedia site is up, I think. This is all in the forums, but some of them are in German, so I have to go through the Google Translate to understand them. And they said that they are continuing developing and updating the game, so we can expect a couple more updates. They want to keep this game alive. So hopefully they add some improvements in the near future. So, and hopefully the community flourishes as well. Now I should have some extra copies for giveaway very soon. So do stay tuned for that. If you're interested to get a copy of this game, stay tuned. I will probably post a giveaway sometime in the next couple of weeks, right? Anyway, that's it for the news. Sorry if it was a bit confusing, but do let me know if you have questions. But yeah, please don't ask me to send you the mods. It is quote-unquote illegal. Maybe without even the air quotes, it is really illegal to be using the DMA mods now. Because as requested by the modder himself, we have to remove them from the upload sites. But if you're using them already, feel free to use them, like what I am doing. Just don't share them further. Yeah, let's end the chain there. Anyway, that's it for that. What happened? All right, in the previous episode, what did we do? We did extend this line, if you remember. If we go back here, in this station, we do have lines specific for TGV. This is this middle one. Let's get the colors in, this orange line. And this flesh line, we did upgrade into these dual stock trains. Beautiful trains, I must say. And we're actually earning 18.9 million there. Money, money, money. Look at that. So many passengers. Perfect. Look at how cool these are. Beautiful. Now, someone commented as well and suggested that we make additional stations here. So, you know this TGV line that we have, the longest train line in this map? And you notice that we were passing through some cities, but we're only like teasing them, like, oh, we have awesome trains, but you can't ride them. So you'll have to go to the northernmost part before you actually get to ride on a train. And I was thinking, even though we can't actually have the TGV stop in these cities in the middle because the TGV would slow down, we can actually make new lines for them, right? So separate lines, totally separate lines. And then we can connect probably Brixham, Abingdon, and what is this? Driffield. These three at the very least, or maybe even four of them, Stockport connected, like a square or circular thing going around the mountain like that. That can work. Yes. And so I did see a new, I think it's not really new, it was in Train Fever, but it was recently ported into Transport Fever. This train station. The modern, Kanshi's modern main station. It's the Hauptbahnhof, I believe, from Germany, from Berlin. Or maybe not only in Berlin. Let's have a look. You should see a name somewhere. Hauptbahnhof. And this is in the Steam Workshop. And if you look at my collection, it should be there as well. Right? Now, if you take a look at the settings here, so many. You can go up to 12 tracks. Humongous train like that. Now it's getting really laggy. Let's turn that down to 4. We can also, now these are only the main tracks, all right? We also have some transit tracks, which means, correct me if I'm wrong, but as I understood it, these are tracks that just pass through, which is exactly what our TGV line should be doing. So if we put, for example, 2 lines or transit tracks, you can see that the lower side increases, the lower part. There are 2 tracks in the middle which have no stations in them. So that means trains just pass through there. Isn't that beautiful? Yeah, we also have transit tracks in the middle. Honestly, I'm not sure what it's for, but I think 2 should be okay. There's also some bit of double allocation here, which I don't really understand what it's for. If you are familiar with this, guys, do let me know if we need it or not and what it's for. Be curious to see how it works. Can also extend it to 480 meters, a monster of a train station. You don't really need that. 240 should be fine. Right, let me close that for now because it's super laggy. Alright, so how many lines do we need? We need 2 transit lines for sure. We need 2 lines to go to this place, to Driffield. So we need 2 more to go to Abingdon? Or no, I think we just need 2. Because those will be just going around. Yeah. So do we just need 2 lines and then 2 transit lines? Might be. And then Stockport. I think we can live with the smallest train station here. In this kind of simple thing. And we can connect this part in here. That would be perfect for the train station. Now let's see. If we can somehow just connect here. Look at this one. Yeah, maybe we can copy that. Let's pause. This will break my trains. These trains are TGV trains, will for sure be going the opposite sides, going the opposite ways now. I don't care, we'll just fix it after. Let's have 2 transit tracks, 240 and then 4 length platform. There we go. That looks good. Actually, that looks nice there. Maybe we go here a bit further like this. There. There. Okay. Not really what I had in mind. Let's try it. Okay, so if we see the 2 tracks here connected in the middle. And then... Actually, we don't really need these 2 yet, so these will just be staying there, just for ornamental purposes. And why is this... Does this really look like that? I'm guessing it's a texture problem again. Yeah, most likely. Okay, so let's delete that further. Delete the signals. Then let's extend this. High-speed tracks in the middle. Connect. All the way there. 272, that will not do. Okay, maybe that will be enough. Yeah, look at that, everything's black now. I hate that bug. So now we have to restart to really appreciate the view. I can't be bothered. Just do that later. Okay. Of course, the road is a problem again. So let's do that. And then connect the roads. Medium? Happy with medium? You know what? Let's build a bridge here. Or build a tunnel. make it look good. Bridge would work. A tunnel could work as well. There. That could do. Not as good looking, but it works. Alright, so at least we don't have any conflicts anymore. And then we can build this one up top for the actual passenger stations. Yeah, but first and foremost, let's go and check on our trains. Has anyone gone the opposite side? So we do have one here. Still facing that way, I think. Okay, good. Where else? I think that's good. We still need... Okay, this one. I'm expecting you turn the opposite way. No, you're good. And you? Okay, everything's good, I think. Alright, let's see later if there's a problem. Don't see anything so far. Nice. This always happens to me. The stations bug out when I start plopping them down the first time. Just like for this other station that we had, Gulumin, right? When we put this down, the whole roof was out. It's awful. Alright, so let's try and connect this. Can we actually use these two here? We can, can't we? One way going that way, one way going that way. But this will have to cross. Yeah, it won't be good. So I was thinking we could use, instead of these two up top, we can use these two below like that. But when we go and try to go to that city, to Driffield, then this has no problem, but this has to cross. So we need to build a bridge and go around it, and it's just, why not just use this top one instead? Makes life much easier, right? And then somehow we can just connect like that, maybe. Eventually. Right? Yeah. Alright, so let's make some stations in here as well. If we're going that way, we could probably do something here. A station here. A simple one. No need to be fancy. Just this modern looking one. Two stations. High speed. Catenary, yes. Delete that actually. Because we need to be somewhere over here, most likely. Like that. And connect this medium street like so. Oh, that's ugly. Maybe that works here. Train 12. Which one are you? The oil train. Okay. Currently, the oil train has 315 meters. The replacement is... there is nothing. Crap. Alright, we have to take care of this first. This one, right? Oil train, yeah. So the crocodile with... oh, crap. The train is gone. Yeah, this is a problem. Pause first. So this train is a class E94, but the E94 is gone. So we'll need a strong but slow train. The one which has the most tractive effort. Let's see, 177, 260, which is our winner, 314, 300. This is our strongest one, this one. But it's 16 million and it goes too fast, so we don't need that. The next one is probably 200, 260, 235, 300, 300. That can work. 314 and 300, that's close. Yeah, it can go, and it can go 160. Yeah, let's take that. The class 185. Ah, I remember. Yeah, you guys were telling me about class 185 to use that. Yes, we can do that. So let's color you black. And add how many? 20. tank wagons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Perfect. Replace you. And voila. Let's go and see. What's happening there? Okay. So this should get replaced already, right? 32 years replaced. Why aren't they getting replaced though? Maybe in a bit. Let's go and check. So we are earning 50 million there. Let's see if that will improve or not, because that should speed up the trains tremendously. But I'm not sure if that should also increase the running costs tremendously. So we'll see. Okay, we got sidetracked there, guys. Let's keep that in and let's proceed. All right, so we are building this passenger line, right? And I want to connect this one like so. That's a bit ugly looking, to be honest. Can we not connect further in? That will be replaced soon. Should be when he unloads. Come on. Am I doing something wrong? 100% yes. Oh, maybe that one hasn't. That's 50 years. Yeah, there we go. It changed. Look at that. Beautiful train. Beautiful looking train. So the old one is 315 meters. The new one is 316 meters. Top speed is now 160 though. So you can see how fast it is. That looks beautiful. That's worth a shot right there. That looks super modern. Can I have a closer shot? Maybe not. It's an electric train, isn't it? Let's take that shot. Beautiful. Super sleek. Although, if you look at the speed, only going 90. Because the travel time is super short. But maybe going that way, since they're not stopping on this station, they have a bit more time to accelerate. Yeah, and this one should get replaced as well. Alright, good, good. Okay, let's keep that. Where are we? Here. I wanted to connect to these. So if I wanted to do that, I could probably just go straight like that and then connect. There we go. There we go. That was easy. Like so. Then just hug this one. Go straight the entire way. And connect eventually to this thing right here. Let's go back a bit. Because we have to come from here as well on this side, and we have to merge to that other lane. So let's say if we just go straight here, and if I want to connect somehow, let's go straight like that and connect you like that. Perfect. So if I want this to be as gradual as possible, that is 300 right there. Okay, this is actually exactly what we needed. Look at that. Now this is not 300, but I think it's pretty close. Should be good enough. I'll take that. And let's extend one more. Oh, that's kind of laggy. Rip. There we go. Let's stick to that one. I really like these four laners. The more lanes, the better looking, isn't it? Okay, just a little more stick there and everybody happy. Perfect. Okay, cool. Now we might need crossover thingy in here, just in case. Too much lope, huh? Why can't you be friendly with me? Maybe if we have this one go first and connect from this other side. Too much lope. Unbelievable. Alright, maybe just have one of them then. Or we can have it as gradual as that. If this doesn't work, I don't know what to do. Okay, that won't work. Let's just leave it like that. One crossover should be good enough. Alright, we have that set up. We have this set up, but this one is not connected. Actually, crap, we have this the opposite way, don't we? This one should be connected there. But it looks much better if we see the front of it here. So what I'll just do is I'll just upgrade this to have a second street connection. And can we play with these settings, the double allocation thing? Because I don't really understand it. 1 plus 2, something changed there. Yeah. I don't get it. Is it like a technical thing but doesn't have anything to do with the functionality in game? Let's just have no double allocation. Second street connection. And then connect to this street right here. There we go. And then we can have a bus station here and connect stuff together. Yeah? In memory of the DMA mods, this one's one of those, my favorite bus station. I did see one other station in the Steam Workshop though, it looks good as well. Might have a look at that. There. It might be a bit too close here though. That wouldn't give us any allowance to expand. Anyway, let's see. So, where are you guys headed? Let's close this road here. Okay. So where are you guys headed? For sure, the straight one. And then we can probably go and go around the place. So we can say, if we're making bus stops in here, maybe make this one? Coming from here, we go until this area. We go around till this area right here. Yes. Then go around till this intersection. Maybe. Let me see. Maybe here would be okay. And then the next one could be in here. And the next one could be in this industrial area. And then the last one would be over here, I guess. Yeah, so our line should look like here to here, going around the place. Now we are not going through there though, that's the problem. So we might have been better to go around, I don't know. Let's leave it. 7 and 8, and then go around. Okay, let's say that's the bus in, what is this place, Brixham? Yeah, I think it is. Bus in Brixham. And let's get a depot over here. I haven't seen any depots in the workshop. Maybe I haven't been looking that well. Let's go and add city bus. Three of them. Make that 4. sign you to the bus in Brixham. So the frequency here should be 60 seconds, which is very good. Alright. And then that connects to this station, and then we can go and build a station here as well. How do we do this though? This would require a much smaller station, because this one is just too big. Or is it? Just fitting perfectly right there. That works. Okay, so in terms of bus stops, we can have something. I think we can connect this. So we can have bus stops over here. And then we can stop over here. Connect that to this commercial area. And we go around this. Wait. Only thing is, we'll not be going through the highway that way. So it might not be the fastest. Let's also connect this one. Oh no. Oh no. Why? I'm just connecting you. Right, maybe not. So then we put more bus stops over in this place. We ignore that industrial area completely. Might not be a good idea. And we... And I built it on the wrong intersection. Should be here. Make sure not to click the wrong one. There you go. That looks... wrong. Okay, I see. I see what we can do. We can connect these two. And then put bus stops around. So we go there. We go here. And then we can stop here in the middle. Like that. And then there. And then going back to this place. Yeah. So if we plot that in, we start from here. We go around. We pass through there and go through all the different districts. Okay, looks good. Let's call this the bus in. What place are you? The Grove. Is it? No, it's the, that's the bus stop. If I close you, actually Abingdon, all right. Bus in Abingdon. There, almost set. Few final touches and we should have our line set at least for one leg. In the next episode, we can continue the other leg to that other city up in the mountains. Let's go and do... is it a long journey? Let's have 3 for now. Bus and Abingdon. There we go. And now all we need is a train. And I guess a crossover in here. So we need something like that. Can I connect this as well? Of course not. Yeah, we don't really need it. Let's just leave it like that. Okay, so if we make a line from here to here, it should use that top part. There we go. Are you using both lines though? You are not. So I would need to put some signals in there. So if we look, it's using only one side of the train, of the tracks. That means we need to put in signals. You can see the immediate effect of this one. In here, maybe. Wait a minute. There wouldn't be anything there. But maybe eventually there would be. I don't know. Okay, so we can just copy this one, the tracks here. Let's put one there and one here. There we go. A single signal there gives the sign to the game that, okay, you might want to use both tracks. Because I prefer this to be a one way. Although you can explicitly say one way like that, it's not really needed. The game is smart enough to know what you want to do. So those make it much fewer clicks. Wow, this is ugly alignment. For those people with OCD, probably not gonna like it, huh? Let's add one more here. There we go. I think I deleted one of those. Like, in here, I deleted one of those. Probably. Yeah, and in here, probably like that before the merge. Also, we need one here before the merge. That is... okay, I put it on the wrong side. It has to be here instead of on that side. Because a train would be coming from this, right? But he would need to stop because maybe another train is on the station, which is going to blend in and cross to the other side. So he has to wait here on this end. Makes sense? Right? Now that's good. We need a depot, which we currently do not have yet. Can we put something in here? Maybe. Yeah, we can. Let's put something in this overpass. Something parallel, I guess. Something like that. And then we can simply connect the road from here to... Will not work. Too sharp. So let's instead do it the other way around. Do it like that. And then put the depot somewhere here in distance and try to connect these two. Ugly looking. No way. Okay, there we go. That's looking much, much better. So we try to connect this one and there. So that means this depot can have a train go to either line, on this line or on the top line here, right? Flatten out, and we are good to go. Let's have our first trains. What do you guys think? Let's go for the cheaper one first. The Mirage, I think, is the cheapest one we have, yeah, because these are fairly small cities. Although they can only go 125, which is not a bad thing. Yeah, let's go with that. Let's have two of you send you to that line. You are called the train circle line. Because this will eventually circle around. Well, right now it's still in progress, so it's not quite accurate. But it will be, believe, alright? There we go. Why did it go? Yeah, okay, that makes sense. Yeah, so it goes through that lane right there. Frequency is 3 minutes. That shouldn't be that bad. Are we getting any passengers here? Just one. So I'm assuming we're losing money there. Yes, we are. That's fine. That will take time, but that will shape up. Right? And then in here, we are actually... Yeah, still losing money. Also losing money. And we have... But we are starting to get some passengers in. That's okay. That will take shape as we go along. And then eventually, we'll extend this to maybe this here. And this will connect to the city of Driffield. Somewhere over on this station, probably. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Look at this. I want to see the TGV pass through here. That would look so cool. Okay, incoming. Let's go here inside. Just the train spotter over here. Look at that, the TGV. That looks so cool. If only we were using these two as well. Might be too small for this station. Yeah, a bit too old as well. It's the cheapest one, so let's be cost efficient. Alright, good to go. We don't have any passengers yet, that's for sure. It will take time, but we'll see. We'll see in the next episode how it goes. Anyway, as always guys, comments are welcome, suggestions, what we want to do, how to improve stuff, if you want to expose and tap a certain resource or city, let me know. Always open to suggestions. In the meantime, that's going to be it. Thank you for watching, and if you did like the episode, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more updates. In the meantime, this is the Clumsy Geek signing off. Thanks for watching, and you guys have a nice day, right? Bye-bye.